Hello friends, let us today discuss about the 17th century English poetry. After the great poet Shakespeare and the dramatist cum poet Ben Jonson's great influences, 17th century English poetry was divided into separate groups. The early 17th century poetry was classified into three groups. The first one is the followers of great poet Spenser, that is a Spenserian school of poetry. And the second group is metaphysical poetry, that is headed by John Donne. The third group is Ben Jonson's group, or followers of Ben, or sons of Ben. And at last, it is called Cavalier poetry. These three groups were influencing the later school of poets who were also called neoclassical poets. Let us first look at Spenser's school of poetry. Spenser, though was a great poet, his influence that could not sustain for a long time in 17th century left a minor group of poets like Fletcher and others. Their poetry, though, was carrying the tradition of Spenser, could not make a great influence. However, the second group that was headed by John Donne, which came to be called metaphysical poetry, survived for a long time, influencing later writers. Especially in the 20th century, the metaphysical poetry was revisited and considered to be one of the greatest school of thinkers and writers as far as its diction, language, and the experimentation in writing is concerned. Metaphysical, as the term suggests, is beyond physical, looking into more spiritual aspects, using religious and material world of human beings. The metaphysical poetry, as the term suggests, is characterized by the experimentation in terms of invoking heterogeneous ideas together. The ideas are sometimes violent in nature. It is the ransacking of ideas together. The use of conceit, images, and the ideas are far-fetched in nature. Metaphysicals were significant because of their experimentation in the images, similes, or metaphors. In total, the figure of speech that they used made them really the different poets who succeeded in almost revolting against the Elizabethan ideals. The Elizabethans, who used emotion, imagination, and nature, were absent in metaphysical poetry. Poets like John Donne and George Herbert were foremost in using love and religion as a material for their poetry. John Donne's poems like Good Morrow, Canonization, or Go and Catch the Falling Star, Ecstasy, etc. are great poems establishing love as a major theme in his poems. And John Donne's use of images, especially the image of a compass or the image of, say, the idea of this love or sensitiveness and sensuousness that combine the elements of human beings in the form of, say, this idea of the compass is known throughout the world, and since 17th century, the idea of twin compasses came to be considered as a great symbol of lovers uniting and rotating around one another. Dunce's influence is followed by many writers in the succeeding days, especially the poets like Richard Crashaw, Henry Vann, and George Herbert, to a great extent, followed Donne in experimenting in the same line of this use of images. Well, after Donne, it was George Herbert who was more a religious poet, expressed his conflict, his early days of struggle, etc. in his poems like Collar. The best example to understand Herbert's conflict is Collar. His physical violent attitude shows his conflict regarding how to approach God or how to reach the world of God. His struggle for religious serenity or composure can be seen in his poem Collar. When he strikes and gets no reaction, he was frustrated. That frustration of Herbert is silenced by the God's gentle approach, and how Herbert accepts that approach of God as if it is like reaching a child, innocent child, just as mother did it. God seems to be so motherly in tender nature. George Herbert is able to reach the God and unite himself religiously in the, say, approach to get the blessings of God. Similarly, a poet like Crashaw also shows his metaphysical concern in his poems. This is how metaphysical poetry influences the later day writers. The third group is group of Ben Jonson's followers. Ben Jonson, who influenced poets with his, say, following the ideals of nature or the smaller significant aspects of nature, makes his, say, followers influence others. Well, this is the early days of 17th century English poetry. Among these three groups, metaphysical stand as the great influences of the later day poetry. Let us see in the next period the influence of Ben Jonson and others. Thank you.